Okay, YouTubers and anti-nuke activists, I got my cup of coffee at 7:31. It's the 12th of October, 2013. Just last night, spent a lot of time finishing up my article on the rooftop grabs, which is the smoking gun evidence of what the nuclear power plants detected here in the United States. And it's really an interesting article. Not a lot of writing. You don't have to read a lot. Just look at the screen captures and my explanation. And there's my graphic right there of all the nuclear power plants here in the U.S. that reported fallout. Again, it was a voluntary basis, because if you look at the NUREG manual, the Rules and Regulations Manual 50.72 stipulates that in the event you have an unscheduled release at your nuclear plant and it's over a certain amount, you have to report it to the NRC. Whether the NRC reports it or not, I don't know. But it's strictly voluntary if the radiation detected is not from your plant. If it's not from your licensed activities, you reporting it is done only on a voluntary basis. So all of this information was gathered up and sent to the National Energy Institute. NRC had access to it. EPA had access to it. Federal Family had access to it. But it was not advertised to the American public. It's an excellent article, not even explaining here kind of how they do the rooftop grabs, and to keep in mind that these rooftop grabs don't draw necessarily 24 hours worth of air through a filter and then test that filter. It could be an hour's worth, could be 4 hours, and then they test it. So keep in mind that the human body, the lungs are breathing around the clock basis. These rooftop grabs are just a short period of time and then a sample. So if you take that short period of time, you're going to need to multiply it and then take it even further out, because the plumes were ongoing many months. Even to this day, they're saying the radiation levels have reached a two-year high at Fukushima just the other day. So it's certainly ongoing. And there's the criminal activity. We weren't given warnings of any sort whatsoever. And so we're looking for very, very high cancer rates in the very near future. We're just getting into the edges of some of these very severe cancers, going down into the bone on the West Coast, the breast cancer. My wife's dad has a stage 3 lung cancer, and it's on to the rib, is my understanding. I don't know if it's going into the rib, but I know it's attached to the rib or on the rib. So it's very serious, and we're all beginning to feel the effects. And the question is, do the people wake up in time to realize where all these cancers came from and to do something about it? So if you get the chance, please go down and have a look at this article. I have already inserted it into my book, Something Wicked This Way Comes, which is a story of Plume-Gate, the world's largest provable cover-up and conspiracy, which is being ignored around the table, across the board, across the spectrum. It's being ignored by the so-called anti-nuke movement, by the so-called alternative media figureheads like Alex Jones. It's being ignored by the mainstream. When you look at where we're looking at right now, the actual rooftop grabs and readings, let me zoom in and get you a little closer picture of them. You know, this stuff that you're looking at right here was likely meant to be redacted. And there are people inside the NRC who are on our side, who are doing their best to let some information slip out. And I have all ideas that this was slated to be redacted, as a couple things I found in these documents appeared as though they were slated to be redacted, but somehow were not. And we're able to see the numbers here. And again, if you look at these, what's amazing is if you consider the amount of time of ongoing emissions, this is the proof right here. We've been bombarded for, I don't know, what, 2 years now? 2 years now. So it wasn't just a week's worth of data, which is what I have here, and what little bit we're able to find in the FOIA documents. It just covers about the span of a week. What we know is emissions are ongoing for years, literally for years. We just had a spike not long ago. So that's what you want to keep in mind. They'll say it's harmless levels, but that was based on modeling for 96 hours or 4 to 5 days, not modeling over a month, not modeling over 2 months, not modeling over a year. And granted, your initial emissions from the incident will be massive, and then it will taper off and you have spikes here and there. But over a long period of time, you'll have low levels of ionizing radiation. That's very, very dangerous, because we know the fetus, pregnant women, they can absorb up to 1,000 times as much in the thyroid. So what might not be harmful to us is very harmful to the little guy, to the baby, to the fetus. Again, this strikes back to the crime, the criminal conspiracy, the cover-up. No warnings given over here whatsoever. And that's what Alex Jones and these so-called anti-nuclear people are protecting the establishment. They do not want to discuss this cover-up, which shows who said what and when, and it proves this massive multi-agency conspiracy. We are going to lose millions of Americans that could have been saved. That's a fact. The crime is that grotesque. It is that horrific. And again, this is, you know, we're in October 2013. These documents have been out since July of 2011. You know, I'm a former alcohol, cocaine abuser, okay? I have ADHD. I'm undiagnosed, but I'm sure I have it. And I'm also have dyslexia to a certain degree. In this time that all these people have ignored this massive provable conspiracy where all the evidence is in these documents, I myself have managed to kick the habit, get straight, and begin writing articles and assemble those articles because I have ADHD, so I can't write a whole book. I can't sit down and say, I'm going to write a 300-page book and let's get on it. I do article after article, and then those articles I assemble in order, and then I have my book later. That's how I got around this and was able to do this. So my point being, in all this time, okay, and over two years, 900 plus something days, the best we've got out of some of these people is just to briefly mention this and go on their way. And they had to do that because I was writing articles calling them out, saying this figurehead won't talk about it, this figurehead won't talk about it. A former drug addict with ADHD wrote a whole book about it. They still haven't hardly had the time to even talk about it, apparently. So keep in mind, once you familiarize yourself with Plume-Gate, this massive multi-agency cover-up and conspiracy, you can then pull the wool back, the illusion fades away, and you're able to look inside and you're able to see who works for the establishment. It's quite shocking. You know, Kevin Blanch recently has been pointing out all these controlled opposition figureheads. They're numerous. They're many. They're popular. You know them by name. You see them all the time. People are posting their videos. You see them on Facebook. They never talk about the silver bullet Plume-Gate. That should be a red flag to you that that person is not genuine. They're not serious about shutting down nuclear power, and very likely they're controlled opposition. The theory behind controlled opposition is you actually pay someone to attack you. Okay, but you control that person. You control the points they attack you on. You control how successful they are. Maybe they stop the fight altogether. Maybe they bungle the fight. Maybe they lose the fight intentionally, like a fighter taking a dive in the third round in the ring. Like Pulp Fiction, if you ever watched that movie, Bruce Willis's character is supposed to take a dive in the ring. They're going to make a whole lot of money off of him. That's what controlled opposition is. It's so effective, they have placed it in nearly every direction I look. And the proof is in the fact that when you send this information on Plume-Gate around, and a lot of people have been experiencing this and writing back to me and saying, look, I've been blocked, I've been deleted. This guy says it's not important. And they're scratching their heads like, this doesn't make any sense. This is huge. This is huge. Okay, this is your depth sound. Send it around and find out who all is unwilling to promote or discuss or even to learn just the basics of Plume-Gate so they can, when they discuss Fukushima, a radiation from Fukushima, the catastrophe, they can throw in that fact there's a massive, provable, multi-agency cover-up. And there's plenty of names, Elliot Brenner, and Jack Sko, Stephen Chu, Barack Obama, the Holdren. I've got evidence where they send information to the president's science advisor. It's huge. You know, we're 900 days in. Alex Jones won't talk about it. Claims to be the conspiracy king, but for some reason he's avoiding the world's largest provable conspiracy that a former drug addict with ADHD and dyslexia was able to write an entire book, and he still has not covered this. He hasn't highlighted it, showcased it. He'll do it with Fast and Furious, but they're avoiding this big one. So this is going to end up sum up my video right here. Please go to the website. I've got the Emperor Wears No Clothes, NPP Nuclear Power Plant Rooftop Grabs, Reveal Picture of Widespread Fallout Over U.S. I've got the Fear and Loathing, which has been very popular recently. It debunks the alternative and the mainstream's take on Unit 4, that it's about to collapse, and if they pull the fuel out, it could everything blow up and we're all going to die. That's total bunk. I've debunked that as well. Let's go to that. Fear and Loathing on Fukushima Unit 4. It's quite extensive. It's probably the largest collection of evidence on Unit 4 in the world right now. If you really want to know what they said about Unit 4 on the telephones and behind the closed doors during the catastrophe. This is all the information, trajectories, plume models, measured plume maps, all the information about the Zerk fire and the meltdown and the rubble on the floor, the walls blown out, loss of water, all that stuff is here. So I'm debunking their propaganda, and at the same time I'm able to call them out and say, look, I've written an entire book proving this. Why are you still silent on this? If you really want to shut down nuclear power, if you're really the conspiracy king, you would jump on this right away and you would promote this and highlight it and showcase it, and they just don't do that. So again, I'm resting my case. 900,000 days in, I've been able to write an entire book on it, and I still can't find an excuse for them. Okay, thanks for joining me for this video. This is HatrickPenry, going to disc golf today. Over and out.